was out. I can't find a tap where you're supposed to find water. I always thought it was around the corner to water the flowers. Anyway, there's Millie up there, Amelia, and her daughter. One of the daughters is the same age as me. One's alive, but she doesn't communicate much with me. Here's a Kent Briggs. That Briggs person there is a connection. Most people in this graveyard are. So there's the Bingay again, and the Petite. All these in there are related. There's Bingays. And Alice Turner. And what's this one here? Oh yeah, this was a Tilbrook, that's right. That's a Tilbrook. Old grave there, don't know what that one is. Yeah, I don't know what that one is, that could be a Lacey. They've got those sort of graves. I've probably got it written down somewhere. It was quite some time before I cottoned onto these two here. First of all, didn't even see her. Didn't see either of them. Ernest Smith's married to my first cousin, Amelia. And they used to run the pub. And that's her daughter, Linda. And there's another daughter who's on Ancestry.com who... She shares stuff with me and I share stuff, sort of. She hasn't made any contact there or desire to meet me or anything. I think she's probably made contact. There's lots of funny rumours about our family. So. Violet Edith, we got Starlings in the family, see? Violet Edith Starling, born 31st of October 1904, died 23rd of July 1995, and Mark Starlin, born 1903, died 1997. Got Starlins, I didn't really take much notice of that one before either. We've got these two now. When I was visiting, she was died in 88, a long time ago, but Amelia, down the bottom there, she was still alive when I first was coming here. He had died a month before, because I can remember we went in the pub. And it was still very oldie-worldie, me and Zara, when we went in the pub. In 2005, the first time we visited here was July 2005, and he would have been warming the ground. We never knew nothing about him. We'd never been here before. And now, to be quite honest, there's so many people related to me in this place. Many. There's the Elstons here. I've got pictures, many pictures of them over the years, these two. And I found a connection with them with West Huntsville in Somerset. And some people who live in Australia have got connections with them as well. Briggs's, oh yeah, Mary Ann Briggs, yeah, and wife of Luke, yeah, that's right, we've got all these are all related to me. Most of these are all related. And it's all been mentioned before. Now, in the early days, it was an audio pod. I just had a handheld tape recorder and came round. So you have to to listen to that and it can be quite crackly, but it has been saved. And I've shared it on Facebook, not Facebook, Ancestry.com. It's been shared. I've got a feeling somebody married a pledger and a wedge. But I can't remember the top of my head anymore because we've got so many connections. So many connections in this graveyard. Without having my laptop here open in front of me, I can't tell you. If I had that, well, I have got it in the car, but I could just click on pledger, for example. I went on family tree and it would all come up. All the details would come up. Well, we've done Stetchworth, Dullingham and now Burrough Green. Like I said, I wanted to really stay up here and wander around and meet people and all that, but there ain't time. Not in 2 days. First of all, it was going to be a week, you see. But I had to do other things. I had to do them while I had the chance. Harriet Briggs, yeah. John Briggs, they're all related. All of them. The Copelands, I don't think they are, but they were probably neighbours of my family's. That was what we're right now. Cool the earth down. Just church. We got Jaggard, yeah, we got, and of course don't forget my ex-husband Dave Lockwood's family on his father's side. Come back to, they actually got some people in there as well. I think they're connected to the Jaggards. And of course Isaacsons, they've got Isaacsons in their family as well. I'll just take some more photos of you three, because you're always showing up around the tree. These will be the latest ones to go on. Stephen. My times four great-grandfather. And Mary Brown in there. And then we've got Edward. And Mary Ann Brooks. I know she's in there, because when I first came, I pulled away some earth. And I found her name. But they dig them deep. These stones, Stephen and Edward, are much taller, really. They're much taller. They've been embedded like this to protect them and to make them safe so they don't have to be put up against a wall. Some flowers to brighten you up like I always do, but it's been like 5 years, 4 or 5 years. You aren't forgotten. I've got a lovely big picture of the church on my bedroom wall and this your rear view. Yeah. So you're always with me, Okies. You're tying me to this village, it's so important. Guppy place now though, isn't it? A guppy, guppy place. Pledger, another pledger there. John Harwood Wedge, I mean. John Harwood Wedge, and there's another wedge. Yeah, we did have somebody married to one of these wedges in the past. It was an oak, and that's probably why they're next to them. Because this little group of people were connected. I'm taking photos as well as doing the video. I don't like to leave you, actually. I've missed you for all these years. And I've just managed to get here. Right, just turning off again to save this bit. stones of the oaks and the wedges. Mary Ann Oak, that's the girl. That could be Edward Oak there. I'm quite sure I can't make that one out. Yeah, and then we've got the wedge footstones as well. So everything is still there. The Oak family. Edward Oak died in 1852, 100 years before I was born he died. And Mary Ann Oak, who was a Briggs, she died in 1887. And they're buried here, my ancestors. Mary Oak there. That one with a nice cross on it, that's Mary. She was quite a important person at one time. They were busy people. I know you've had to wait quite a long time for me to come. I haven't forgotten you. Oakies. Zara's been here, at least one of them's been here. But of course they don't have the same feeling as me, I don't think. Because they didn't do the research and the work, you see. It's lovely, that sunflower, isn't it? So bright and cheerful. Roses. My mother liked roses. Of course, on my dad's side, we've got some people over there. They came here in the war. As a land girl, married a local boy, a turner, or a smith. I think it might have been a smith. And yeah, it was a smith. Just go around the graveyard again. Jaguar, there we go. Jaguars, I think, are connected to my ex. Private 14511 W Jaguar, Suffolk Regiment, 5th of August 1916, aged 21. He died in the First World War, in other words. So I'll do your picture again. I've got you, but just going round again, like I always do. I always go round again. I can't find a water tap. Brinsley James Willard. He died 1956, aged 64. The Golden Gate is left ajar. Also of a devoted wife, mother, Nana, and great Nana, Ethel Willard, who died 13th of July 2005, aged 105. Wow. Now I've got a granddaughter called Daisy. She was born on the 13th of July 2003, when you were still alive and you were 103. I'm not sure of our connection yet, but I always, there's another one, but I am doing more because I don't know when I'll come back. I don't know when I'll be back. And then we've got Frederick C.W. Pledger, died on the 3rd of March 1970, aged 69, and Ada Pledger. Dear wife, mother, and grandmother, who died 19th of July 1999, aged 98. They lived good years here. That's a pleasure. Of course, the Smith family could possibly be connected to my first cousin's husband. He was a Smith. So I'd taken a picture of this grave, Eliza Mariam Smith, 1900 to 1960. John Taylor Smith, that sounds very familiar, John Taylor Smith, 1899 to 1972. And Frederick Louis Smith, 1969, he died, age 74. Actually, she went to sleep, Eliza Mariam, on the 27th of January, 1960. That's my birthday. I was 8 years old. Like I said, we've got so many people in this graveyard that we're related to. It takes me a while just going around saying hi to everybody. I'm sure there was a water, like a hole in the wall or something once here. We could get water out. Good job I had some water with me, wasn't it? There's a Claydon here. Wait a minute, we can't miss you out, Mary, can we? She died in 1953. Mary Claydon. Died 1953. Doesn't say how old she was or anything. Could have been a small child. And there's another one here. John Claydon. He died in 1943. Could be forgotten graves now. It's like, well, if I don't ever come, who's going to put flowers on theirs? They've had to wait 5 years for me. Other names, there'd be others. After this place, we're going to Westleigh Waterless. And depending how tired I am, I might do Soham. I ought to do Soham really, because flowers won't last, I know. There were some plastic ones on there once. They've gone. Some new ones, look, since I've been here last. 2019 was the last time I was here, so that lady there, she was only 64. Younger than me, she's died since I was here last. So 2000, what time did I say? 2019 I was here last.